Inside Track with Bob McAdorey.
Hi, good afternoon. Welcome to this edition. Okay, music aficionados, here are the top 10 from Billboard magazine.
Cause it's on N-A-T-E-N-E, the woman to the G.
Don't turn around, cause you're gonna see my heart, baby. Don't turn around, yeah. Ooh, baby, I love your way, every day.
To be the most beautiful girl in the world. Baby, judge what you say, you want another time to
say. I'm on the side.
Top three singles in Canada, according to the magazine The Record, are Springsteen's Streets of Philadelphia, Celine Dion's The Power of Love, and Mariah Carey's Without You. Now let's check in with Mike Anscombe in the Global Newsroom for this update. Mike?
Thank you, Mike. Good afternoon, everyone. Tensions are running high once again in Oka, Quebec. The local Mohawks have begun tearing out the disputed road which leads to the Oka Golf Course. That's the same land that triggered the Oka crisis 4 years ago. The federal government has appointed a lawyer to negotiate a settlement, but the Mohawk leaders say they are tired of waiting. In the Commons today, Native Affairs Minister Ron Irwin urged Native leaders to remain calm and give the negotiations a chance.
I'm going to do my best, and my officials will do their best, and so will our negotiator and our mediator, to convince the people of Gunasatagi that that's not the way to proceed. If they want to help the people, then the leadership there has to be more calm in the situation. I think we're making progress, and I hope to report in the next couple of weeks.
The Ray government has jumped into the separation debate. Economic Development Minister Francis Lankin is quoted today as saying Queen's Park is devising a plan to protect Ontario businesses should Quebec leave Canada. She said the plan will include strategies to develop economic relations with an independent Quebec. And there is some ominous news from Northern Ontario, the community of Elliott Lake specifically. The grandmother of missing toddler Katie Lynn Brasso says her son told her last weekend that he intended to kill himself and take the little girl to heaven. The child's father, Richard Brasso, was found dead in his truck on Monday. Police say he had shot himself. There has been a frantic search in the area west of Sudbury for the 2.5-year-old girl ever since. The child's grandmother, Jeanette Brasso, said she thought she had talked her son out of committing suicide during the weekend. She said he had been distraught over the recent breakup of his marriage. Details at 5:30 on First News. Mike?
Thank you, Mike, and thank you for looking in. Enjoy your afternoon. I'll see you back here in a half hour at 2:30 on the Entertainment Desk.
How did it happen? How did I become an addict? I don't know. It seemed like it was the only thing that I could do, right? And I enjoyed it. I didn't have anything to worry about. But then it took over my whole life, and I hurt all my family. I didn't like the person that I became, and I didn't know how to stop. Today I know how.
A message from Concerned Children's...